How to use RL200HVG correctly. Check in the leveling accuracy. Mount the instrument in the horizontal position onto a tripod or place it on a firm and level surface near wall. Switch the instrument on. Position the X-axis to aim to a wall or a target plate. After the leveling, mark the center of the laser beam on wall, point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees, allow it to level in and mark the center point of the laser beam on the wall, point H2. The difference D of both marked point H1 and H2 on wall is the actual deviation of the instrument for the measured axis. The value of D deviation should be less than 5 over 16 inch or 8 millimeters. Repeat the measuring procedure for the Y-axis. Position the Y-axis to aim to a wall or target plate. After the leveling, mark the center of the laser beam on wall, point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees, allow it to level in and mark the center point of the laser beam on the wall, point H2. The difference D of both marked points H1 and H2 on wall is the actual deviation of the instrument for the measured axis. The value of D deviation in either axis should be less than 5 over 16 inch or 8 millimeters. Check in the vertical alignment. Mount the instrument in the vertical position onto a tripod using mount accessory or place it on a firm and level surface near wall. Switch the instrument on, position the up beam to aim at wall A or target plate. After the leveling, mark the center of the laser beam on wall A, point H1. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees without changing the height. Allow it to level and mark the center point of the laser beam on wall B, point H2. Without turning the instrument, position it close to wall B by moving the tripod. After instrument levels, align the height of the instrument so that the center point of laser beam is exactly on point H2 of wall B. Rotate the instrument by 180 degrees without changing the height. Allow it to level and mark the center point of the laser beam on wall A, point H3. The mark of point H3 should be marked in such a way that it is as vertical as possible, above or below of point H1. The difference D of both marked points H1 and H3 on wall A is the actual deviation of the instrument of the measured axis. The value of D deviation should be less than 3 over 16 inches or 4 millimeters.